everything I say.
I love being a private school girl.
You got some soft lips and some pearly white. I wanna touch him in the dead of night.
He's eating her face.
Your smile ignites just like a candlelight.
Last time I wanna know
everything's alright. Hey, it's freezing.
Before you, and there was during you. For some reason, I never thought there would be an after you. But there it was, and I was in it.
You told me about your past, thinking your future was me, and you were tossing me the car keys, but the patriarchy, keychain on the ground.
My hands. Close your eyes. Now feel.
Run.
He growls.
If I catch you, I fuck you.
are some BookTok books that I think are absolutely phenomenal. I have zero criticism and I think they're perfect. Disclaimer, just because I love them doesn't mean that you have to. You can hate them. And that's okay. Also, go look at part one for books that I actually hated. But taking up my number one slot for my favorite book ever, this should come as no surprise to absolutely anyone, Throne of Glass by Sarah J. Maas. Oh my word. I think Aelin alone just made that entire series absolutely phenomenal, but then you toss in the world building and the connections from book one to book eight, and it leaves my mind just boggled every single time that I read it. And I've read it multiple times. The only thing that I think that I would have changed in that entire series is, spoiler alert, I would have kept Sam Cortland alive because, ow. Coming in at number two for me is Shatter Me by Tahira Mafi. I think that that book series is so freaking good. I mean, the platonic friendship between Juliet and Kenji Kishimoto is what really made that series so amazing in my eyes. But to be quite honest, I thought the plot from book one to book three was so, so good. 4 to 6 was questionable at best, but whatever, I'll take it. I mean, like, Aaron Warner's in it too, so like that's nice, I guess. But coming in at number three, Incendiary by Zoraida Cordova. Underrated. Perfection. Everything in that book from start to finish was so entertaining. It has everything that you want in a book. It has a ballroom scene, it has the memory loss trope, it has childhood friends to lovers, not to mention that it's set in a fantasy style inspired Spain-like country, which is just so cool in and of itself. Zoraida, I think, is also just such an underrated author. I think more people should read her, but that's besides the point. Coming in at number four, Fourth Wing. It has the hype that it has for a reason. And I'm just gonna say that. I mean, it has sarcastic talking dragons. That alone, plus a shadow love interest, sold me. I thought it was so good. And lastly, I'm going to put Crescent City by Sarah J. Maas. Oh, book two in that series quite actually changed the trajectory of my life, but that's fine. Where is book three, Sarah? Where is book three, Sarah? But I think that Bryce Quinlan is part of what makes that series just so amazing to read. The reason that I loved Bryce so much is because she was so realistic and real. Like, I could be Bryce. So yeah, those are my favorite books. Let me know what yours are because I'll read those too. Yeah. I go round and round, sad.
Come home, you know you can't roam
as
without
I
Caesar.
Recall, I know you love to show off, but I never thought that you would take it this far. What do
I would absolutely die to read again for the very first time if I absolutely could. A Touch of Darkness by Scarlett St. Clair. Oh my god, this book was freaking phenomenal. Oh my god. The Fine Print by Lauren Asher. Whoo, this book was a 10 out of 10 out of 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. Shatter Me. Anyone who knows me knows this book was about to be on this list. Like, come on. Do you even know me? This book was amazing. Throttle by Lauren Asher. I read this whole book in one fucking sitting. No one could tell me otherwise. I'm obsessed. Does It Hurt by H.G. Carlton. Whoo, of course this book is gonna be on this list. I mean, ugh.
Now or forever, you're
I think you might have accidentally saved my life.
There you are, sweetheart. Sorry I'm late. I was looking everywhere for you.